He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
So let's take a look at some questions regarding moles and molarity. The first question asks, two solutions of the same non-electrolytic substance are mixed in the following manner. 400 milliliters of a 1.5 molar solution plus 520 milliliters of a 1.2 molar solution. What is the concentration of the resulting solution? Then the second question asks, how many moles of magnesium phosphate will contain 0.25 moles of oxygen atoms? So some different concepts here regarding moles and molarity. So check out some of my previous tutorials if you need some help. And when you're ready, give this a try. So looking at this first question, we want to find the concentration of the resulting solution. And concentration, in molarity, we're talking about moles per liter. So we need the total moles, and we need the total liters. So if we need the total moles, we need to find the moles in each of the individual solutions. So let's take this first solution. We know that we have 480 milliliters, so let's put that as 0.48 liters, and then let's multiply that by 1.5 moles per liter, because it's a 1.5 molar solution. So by doing this, we are finding out that there are 0.72 moles of this solute in that first solution. Then let's do the same thing for the second solution. We have 0.52 liters of that second solution times 1.2 moles per liter, because it is a 1.2 molar solution. And so that tells us we have 0.62 moles in that second solution. And now, to get the concentration of the total resulting solution, we need the total moles over the total liters. And the total moles is just the sum of these first two, so 0.72 plus 0.62. And then the total liters, we're just adding these two volumes. So we have 0.48 liters plus 0.52 liters. And so if we do that arithmetic, we get 1.34 molar as the concentration for the resulting solution. Now, for this second question, we're talking about magnesium phosphate. So first, we need to know what the molecular formula is for magnesium phosphate. We need to know how many atoms of each element are in this compound. So magnesium phosphate, that is definitely going to be an ionic compound, because we have a polyatomic ion, phosphate, in there. And magnesium ions, the common charge for magnesium is 2+. So we have magnesium 2+ ions. And then the phosphate ion, we just have to have this memorized, like some of the other polyatomic ions. This is PO4 3-. That is what the phosphate ion is. So what is the combination in which magnesium ions and phosphate ions will come together to generate a neutral compound? Well, that is going to be Mg3PO42. That way we have a total of 6+ and a total of 6-, so that does add up to a neutral compound. So we have 3 magnesium ions and 2 phosphate ions. And so what we need to do now, so now we know exactly what's going on and how many oxygen atoms there are per formula unit here. And so we have 0.25 moles of oxygen atoms. And so what we need to do is we need to multiply that by 1 formula unit of magnesium phosphate over 8 oxygen atoms, right? Because each phosphate ion has 4 oxygen atoms, and there are 2 phosphate ions per formula unit. So that is 8 oxygen atoms per formula unit, and that means that 0.031 moles of magnesium phosphate will contain 0.25 moles of oxygen atoms.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.